Recently, we posted several charging compatibility video of OnePlus phones, and many of you guys may notice that there were several original OnePlus chargers showing. Today, we're gonna pick up the latest released 100W SuperVolt charger. It's equipped with a USB-A and a USB-C port. Both can support up to 100W SuperVolt protocol. Let's go ahead and take a look. The packaging continues the OnePlus design in red and white. Open the box. Except for the charger itself, it also comes with a 100W cable. Due to the high current when charging with the SuperVolt protocol, this red rubber cable can support up to 10A. But the USB-C connector does not adopt a full pin design. The cable length is about 1 meter. The charger design is very modern and cool. The surface of the shell is covered with shallow striped grooves, which can facilitate the user to hold it more tightly. The red SuperVolt logo is at the corner. All specs info are printed on the input end, marked as VCBA-UACH. It supports input of 100 to 240 volts, 50 or 60Hz, 2.5 amp. The single output can be up to 100 watts, and the dual output power can be divided into 50 watts and 50 watts. The input prongs can be folded, even for such a small charger. A USB-A and a USB-C are on the upper panel. It still adopts white and red. The size of the charger is about 62.5 by 61 by 31 mm. The weight of the charger is about 178.5 grams. The ChargerLab Power ZKM003C shows the USB-C can support QC 3.0, Vogue, PD 3.0, PBS, Apple 2.4A, DCP protocols. And it has 5 fixed videos of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 12V, 3A, 15V, 3A, 20V, 3.25A, and a set of PBS, which means it can support 65W PD protocol. And the USB-A can support QC 3.0, Vogue, SuperVogue, Apple 2.4A, and DCP protocols. Next, we took apart the charger from the input side. The red and black wires are connected to the input prongs. Then use the cutting machine to cut off the plastic shell. In this case, we could take it out. The entire module is wrapped with heatsink, a black insulating layer, and thermal pad, like a sandwich. And let's remove those heat dissipation measures. The gaps between different components are filled with silicone adhesives for fixing and heat dissipation. Let's clean up the PCBA module. Except for the input filtering circuit, ChargerLab found it integrates two independent switching power supply circuits, which adopt QL flyback topology. And most components are symmetrical, like transformer, capacitor, mass control chip, etc. Let me introduce every single component. The input fuse is from WaterFuse, 3.15 amp, 250 volts. The first common mode choke is insulated with a white heat shrinkable tubing. The green NTC thermistor is from SDE, used to suppress the inrush current when the charger is plugged in. The safety extra capacitor is also from SDE, 0.1 microfarad. The second common mode choke is insulated with a black heat shrinkable tubing. The bridge rectifier is from Pingwei. The thermal pad and silicon adhesive can enhance its heat dissipation performance. 8A, 1000 volts. Those four electrolytic capacitors are connected in parallel for input filtering and are from Anshi RK series. 400 volts, 33 microfarad for each. The differential mode choke is between those capacitors, wrapped with heat-shrinkable tubing. Two mass control chips are from Power Integrations, which is a customized model and suitable for PD, PPS, QC adapters. It can support high voltage switching, synchronous rectification, and flux link feedback. Those two tiny utility capacitors can power two mass control chips, 50 volts, 10 microfarad for each. Those two transformers are insulated with yellow tape. The ferrite core is ATQ23.7, wrapped with copper foil for shielding. Those two SMDY capacitors are from the TRX SMD-Y2 series. The other two SMDY capacitors are also from TRX, but with a different model. And two synchronous rectifiers are from Infineon, 100 volts, 6 milliohm for each. There are four solid capacitors and two USB ports on the output side. Two solid capacitors for output filtering on the left side of the USB-C are connected in parallel from Polycab. The other two solid capacitors on the right side of the USB-A are also from Polycab. After removing all plug-in components, we can now see the protocol chip. It's from Medtronic and can support dual port 18 to 140 watts fast chargers. So both USB ports of this charger are controlled by it. Two output VBUS MOSFETs are from Pingwei, and the 5 milliohm sampling resistor between them is used for output current detection. The other two output VBUS MOSFETs are the same, used to control the two independent output circuits. The USB-C connector is soldered on a separate small PCB. The TVS diode and thermistor are soldered on the back. Well, that's all components of this 100 watts dual USB ports SuperVolt charger. Compared with your original SuperVolt charger inside the box, it can charge two SuperVolt devices at once. After taking apart, we found it integrates two independent output circuits, so both USB ports can reach 100 watts when charging a single device, and the USB-C port can support up to 65 watts PD protocol, so you can charge your PD laptops and SuperVolt smartphone at the same time. Pretty convenient. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. And I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!